get ready to earn our orange belt. So we don't want to use the same spreadsheet. Well, we're going to use the same spreadsheet, but what we're going to do is we're going to add a new sheet down here at the bottom. So we're just going to go ahead and click this plus sign down here. And now it says sheet 3. That's because I had deleted a sheet earlier. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually just go ahead and paste in a spreadsheet. What you're going to do is you're going to go ahead and set one up. You can set it up like this, or if you have a different way of setting it up, you can. So I want to go ahead and text wrap up here. So I'm going to click the 1, and I'm going to come up here to Format, Text Wrapping, and I'm going to tell it to wrap. That way it looks better. So you want everything centered. Now here's what we're going to do is we're going to put formulas in. So on your little sheet, actually, you'll be here on the orange belt. You'll click this link, and it will take you to this sheet right here with all of the instructions that you need. And right here it says use a spreadsheet to figure out how much, and formulas, and here's your example spreadsheet. Now you can, like I said, you can make it any way you want. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to create formulas to double, triple, and quadruple the recipe. And it's a lot easier than you think it is. So let's go back here, and now I want to go ahead and double. One of the things you have to remember on formulas is you always start a formula with the equal sign. So I clicked in this cell right here, and I'm going to go ahead and start with an equal sign. That automatically makes a formula. Now I could type in a 4 here, but if I type in a 4, what's going to happen is if I change this number here, then I have to change my formula. So instead of using numbers, I'm just going to go ahead and click in the cell that I want to double. So you can see that it says C2. Now I'm going to do a multiplication times 2. And then here's the important part. You need to hit enter. So if I hit enter, it went ahead and doubled it. Let's go ahead and click on that cell again. And I'm going to find that black plus, and I'm going to drag that down, and my formula copied. So you can see it's a C4, which is C4 right here, times 2. This one says C5 times 2. So it just copies that formula for you. So let's go ahead and triple this. So to start a formula, we're going to go with equals. Whoops, not a plus sign. Equals. And then I'm going to go ahead and click on this cell right here again, because I'm going to triple this cell. So that times 3, enter. And then I'm going to go ahead and get the black plus sign and drag it down. And last equals C2 times 4, enter. Let's go ahead and drag this one down as well. So I dragged it down just a little bit too far, but that's okay because I can come in here and just delete that right there. Hit enter. So now I've doubled and tripled and quadrupled the amounts. Now, if you want some extra practice, because that's pretty easy, if you want some extra practice, you can also put in the costs. So I can put in here cost for one, cost for two. I could put double, whatever, triple. So I'm going to put the costs in. So chocolate is $1.25, and you can label these as well. And water is free. So we're not even going to add that. Sugar is 65 cents. And eggs are 25 cents each. And cream is $1.59. All right. So now what I want to do is I want to go ahead and select all of these and make these dollars. So I can come up here to Format. And where it says number, I can go ahead and say it's currency right here. Okay, so now it looks like currency. So again, cost for double. What I'm going to start with is the equal sign. I'm going to click on the 9, C9, times 2. And there it is. And then I can just click and drag. All right. So then you can do it for the tripling and the quadrupling, and then make sure you put your labels and all of that kind of stuff on there. But that's how you go ahead and add formulas. Now, formulas also have lots of other, there's a lot of other formulas. You have lots of formulas here. There's, and you can learn more, but within each one of these, you have all these formulas that I would never be able to explain to you. I can explain some of them to you, but not most of them. So there's a whole bunch of formulas, or you can create your own formulas, which, as you can see, depending on the kind of math problem you're doing, is relatively easy.